In this video, we're going to be checking out a new world that I made. I put three columns with some holes in the middle so then they can run through, because I really want them to expand quickly in the small column and then start to really colonize the bigger ones. And then eventually there should be one winner. So I'm going to use the four main species. Humans are going to go in the top right corner, elves in the bottom right, orcs in the bottom left, and dwarves in the top left. Turn on villages, names, and borders and click play, and here we go. They're all starting out now. And I'm hoping that putting humans with the elves is more fair than putting them with orcs or dwarves, at least. I feel like the humans have the biggest chance to win when they're up against the elves, even if that chance is still smaller than 50%. I don't know. But the reason why I'm saying that is for anybody who hasn't been watching my channel, we keep score. And orcs right now have 9 points, dwarves and elves both have 3, and humans have 0. So humans really need to step up their game and get at least 1 point on the board. And it looks like there's 2 more empires popping up with Zgen. It's an orcish empire. It's definitely just going to be taken over by Dona Nord though. And an elvish empire setting up in one of the bigger columns. If this elvish empire can actually secure this, that's a big threat to the rest of them. The yellow empire for the orcs are already just completely limited to their expansion right now because this other orcish empire setup. I think that brings a pretty big disadvantage to the orcish species as a whole, as the rest of them, especially the dwarves up here, just can continue to grow bigger and bigger. The elvish empire in the big column just got destroyed? By what though? I don't know who destroyed them, everybody's at peace. The yellow orcish empire has taken over the purple one, but it's still, that just means that the city's gonna stay here and still stunt the growth of the capital. Zgen is basically already bigger than it, just not population wise yet, but it'll catch up. Humans are growing strong and fast with 41 population, which is good because they have one more population than the elves. Never mind, they're tied. And it looks like the elves are also setting up another colony on just on the other side of the wall here, which is actually extremely smart. It's far away from everybody else and it gives them time to develop. Oh, the humans are doing it too. Good humans, yes, learn from the elves. They're smarter than you. Humans need to take notes. So the orcs are at war with the humans and the elves right now. So if we zoom in here and look around, there might be some battles. There's elves running around. Here goes an orc. Where's he going? He's going all the way south there. Oh, they set up a city. Zopop. It's an orcish city. And the dwarves are also. That's cool how they're all doing it, like, up at the... It's gone. What? These wolves must have eaten it. Oh, no. Here we go. The dwarves are setting up another colony. Hopefully, this one doesn't get eaten right away. And here, zooming in here, there's actually some conflict. Okay, so, yeah. There's humans and elves helping each other out, killing these orcs. It's interesting to see how the two species sharing the same column aren't going to war with each other. And the humans and elves are peaceful as well. I figured that one of them would kill each other before the other ones actually started fighting. But the dwarves are going to have to act soon because the orcs are taking over the opening. The elvish city here in one of the big columns continues just to get beaten back by orcs. The humans are actually defending themselves from the orcs. The elves are being beat back more, which is extremely surprising, to say the least. As soon as the humans or elves or orcs or dwarves actually declare war on each other, there's gonna be a lot of death and destruction. They're all actually pretty decently powerful empires right now. Looking at the empire screen, the orcs are in first like usual, with 346 population, the elves are in second with 255, humans in third with 238, and dwarves in fourth with 161. So the dwarves are fourth, and they're right next to the first place. But don't let their numbers deceive you. They're definitely more powerful than any other soldier in the game. I can't believe it. The map is actually starting to fill up. The elves and humans, I would say, are pretty equal right now in terms of territory, but the orcs have just completely dominated over the dwarves. The dwarves have two cities now on kind of like their side of the border, when the elves and humans have it pretty split down the middle, and both of their cities are encroaching on the opening at like the same time. Oh, but now the dwarves and orcs are actually sharing some borders, and long borders too. That's gonna cause some tension between both of them. There's so much fighting in the middle here. I swear they're both just going to war with each other. Nothing much has changed. The orcs are still at war against the humans and elves, and that's kind of it. Oh no, the humans are at war with the dwarves. Okay, so it's literally a side against a side. That's so crazy. So all of the fighting right now is happening in this middle column. You would think though that the dwarves and the orcs would actually overpower him, but it doesn't seem like it. The fighting for the most part is staying in the center. The dwarves are becoming completely landlocked here. This is the last room for them to expand, and the orcs are gonna snag it for sure. They can expand up here, but that's still finite. And that means that the only expansion for the orcs is outwards towards the humans and the elves. Oh, they're setting up in a big army. Yeah, okay. It's gonna be rough for him to actually gain land though. Maybe the humans and elves will actually start to push him back. And if the dwarves and orcs go to war, or the humans and elves go to war, that will really determine which side gains an advantage. The dwarves just cut off the leftmost city, meeting up with this city. What? I mean, the orcs will still just run across, but that's really funny how they actually just took it like that. So much death just constantly happens in the center column here. But the orcs continue just to set up a few more tiles in here. It looks like the elves are snagging in the column first. The humans also got a little tile in here. Oh, there they go, they're expanded a bit more. I can't believe how even the humans and elves are right now. I can't believe how filled in this map is and they're not all killing each other. And it looks like the elves have blocked off the humans. It looks like all the borders are basically finite. There's a few more stragglers that some kingdoms can still get. But for the most part, the elves and the orcs have completely secured everything except for the center part here. I did not expect this to happen. They're like on teams. And having orcs and dwarves on a team is way more powerful than humans and elves on a team. Oh, it's happening! The dwarves and orcs went to war! Just immediately, both of their cities' borders and edges just collapse. It looks like the dwarves have a bigger army rushing through, or at least for now, immediately. Okay, they're definitely pushing through. It looks like the dwarves are pushing the orcs back. Over here, they got a solid army pushing through, as well as the bigger column. The humans and elves are walking in here too, and now they're joining the fight. Okay, the orcs have defended, it seems. They're losing territory fast. And then there's humans up here. What? They're trying to set up a city over here between the dwarves and the orcs. That's amazing. So the dwarves just cleared out the orcs, and now the humans are gonna come up here and just take the opening. The new no man's land has been moved in between the orcs and the dwarves here. All of the fighting's happening here. Whoa. There's every species just chilling, fighting. I mean, they're not chilling. The elves are also trying to set up a city over here. Now the dwarves and the elves are both working together here, just shooting up the orcs. And here comes a big dwarvish army. Whoa. Whoa. They're moved down here with a huge army. They're gonna push the orcs out of the side. Well, no, they still have Zopop with 150 population. I wonder if that's actually able to defend against this. That's a lot of soldiers. And not all of that population is battle ready. Here comes a lot of the orcs from the big city. The population is dropping quick. Oh, okay. And the elves and the humans are going to war. Oh, that's really not good for the humans. But maybe the dwarves have been distracted enough with the orcs. I don't know. The humans are definitely pushing back way more initially, at least in the middle column here. I'm really hoping the humans can get the advantage here. And the orcs have been completely reduced to their remaining column here, with their capital still not able to expand. This human city, though, blocking off the dwarves is doing better than I thought it would. So the humans and elves still matched up over here, both losing a bit of territory. So looking at the empires, we have elves in first place. Oh, that's really not good for the humans. I didn't realize how much of the population difference there was, because elves have 638 and humans have 362 in third. And dwarves are in second place, and of course orcs are in fourth right now, pretty sad, dying. If the humans and elves though just let the dwarves gain all of this land, they're going to become extremely powerful. If anything, the humans being right here have just delayed the orcs' death. Okay, so the elves are at war with everybody. Oh, okay, so that's really good for the humans then, if the orcs and the dwarves are rushing in here too with armies. Oh, there's been a civil war with the dwarves, and that's a big city to go to civil war with. It's just a huge fight between them. The humans have actually got a decent sized city here. And the dwarvish rebellion is over. It's just been reabsorbed back into the empire. And the humans are trying to sneak in another cheeky little city down here. Here comes a huge elvish army. Okay, who are they going to attack? The humans or the dwarves? It looks like so far the dwarves. Please just go for the dwarves. No. If this army went for the humans, they'd be dead. Here comes a huge amount of dwarves trying to wipe out the army before it gets too bad. No way they just wiped out all of those dwarves. That was so many of them. Once elves get a nice bow army, nothing can stop them, man. Oh, okay. Oh, the dwarves went to war with the orcs. They just wiped them out of this column. And they're trying to attack their capital over here through the human city. Slowly but surely, the elves are definitely being pushed back more and more. Oh, okay. The humans just had a civil war. No way! So the Empire is still mostly united, and if they send over troops to there, it's only gonna weaken them. What a horrible way to just ruin the humans' chances. Oh, okay, the dwarves are having a civil war as well. Okay, this is a lot of damage for both of these species. Okay, wow, that city just got completely destroyed for the dwarves. I'm surprised they're all still alive, every species. Oh, okay, the purple humans though just went to war against the dwarves. That's really not good. Oh, they're about to be destroyed everywhere. They're being pushed out completely of the left side of the map. There they go, they're gone. And the orcs are still fighting them too. This might be the end of the orcs now. And there goes the orcs, the last of them. Wow. And now the dwarves just own half of the map. And really the right side is split between three empires because the humans are in two. Oh, okay. The dwarves are going through a civil war. Oh, the population's dropping so fast. Okay, they retook it over. But even this city's still rebelling, taking the most southernmost city, which is barely anything. It's like five buildings. It won't last long, I doubt. I doubt it. there it goes. Now they just need to move that army over to the elves and humans. The elves are being completely pushed out of the second big column. Yeah, it's gone, it's gone. So the elves have one city left and it's their capital. And the humans somehow managed to get a city in the bottom left corner here. Other than that, the humans are still divided. Okay, the dwarves and the humans went to war? The dwarves just annihilated that city. Kusus here? Just the population dropping so fast. The dwarves are wasting no time at all. Both of those powerful human cities just disappeared off the face of the map. Just like that. Just gone. Rip the humans. And they're going to war against the Purple Nation too. This is a disaster for humans. And the elves have now kicked out everybody from every single column except for the last one where the humans and elves started out in. And now the dwarves are coming over here to finish it off. The humans and elves are on a team right now and they're both at war against the dwarves, but they're so small and puny at this point. The dwarves will just slowly come over here and just destroy them. Over time, the humans and the elves are just slowly being pushed back, soldier by soldier. And it looks like this may be the end of the humans. There's 5 population left. 4, 3, 1 population gone. Humans have gone extinct and elves are about to follow. They just have a firing squad of archers here with some soldiers going in, slapping up children, as you do. 11, 10, under 10 population, and it's gone. The dwarves have won. Congratulations to the dwarves. They're finally no longer tied with the elves with 4 points. The orcs still have 9, and the elves still have 3, and the humans are still stuck with 0 points. Although they did make it all the way up to the end here, they had some pretty good plays in the game.